Hello, hello, everybody. It is 8 p.m. Central Time on the 8th of November, 2018. It is Thursday night, going into Friday internationally. Guys, got some breaking news. The largest earthquake to strike the North Atlantic in years has just taken place, and it's the exact magnitude, 6.8, that struck down here off the coast of Greece a week and a half ago. And it's on our arrow, on our transfer zone, coming out of Europe following a 4.0 earthquake up in Poland. This is a huge earthquake for the location, right off the coast of Greenland. The good news is it's small enough that it most likely didn't cause a tsunami of any kind. But I would like to just turn on a display capture, and we're going to go look this up, get the information, and we'll either get it from the USGS or EMSC. We'll go to the USGS, who has it at 6.8. Let's go to the origin page and check the magnitude list, see what they're showing. Okay, they don't even have any magnitudes listed yet. That's how young the earthquake is. Just happened within the past few minutes. And we'll put the coordinates in to get exact location. Here we go. All right, we're going right down next to Jan Mayen. And it's a remote volcanic island, and we're on a fracture zone directly next to it. So it's a fairly large-sized quake, no doubt about that. And we know where it came from. Now here's what happened, and I've got somewhat good news for the people in Europe. Apparently, the force went out around across Romania, out across Poland, and went up to the north, instead of going and splitting across Italy. It also went out to the west somewhat with a 5. Over past Portugal, but the main force on this, it's pretty obvious. 5.5 striking in Romania a few days ago, 4.0 striking in Poland today, now a 6.8, the exact same sized earthquake. Now the Europeans, USGS, oh, just downgrade. They're going to take it down, of course. Without showing us the magnitudes, they're going to take it down. Let's go see. We still don't have magnitudes. It looks like they're adjusting it down to 6.4. They can't have it the exact same size as the 6.8 that hit down at Greece. People might start to ask some questions. So start to play with the numbers, of course. Well, we'll see. But that's where the earthquake came from, no doubt about it. Right now, take a look at it before they change it. There it is, exactly as it came in, 6.8. And we had a 6.8 down here. What are the chances we'd have two 6.8s in the Northern Hemisphere on both sides of Europe in a week and a half? Here, I can go turn on. Let's go look at our last 30-day feed of 4.5 and greater. And we just need to look at the last week and a half. So, really, we don't even have to look at the whole month. Okay, wait for it. There we go. Now they've just updated the earthquake to 6.4, guys. All right, whatever. There it is. So, here's our 6.8. This 6.8 struck on October 25th, like I said. So, you know, about a week and a half, 2 weeks ago. So 1 week ago was the 31st, and then 5 days before that, or 6 days before that. So, you know, 2 weeks ago, basically, almost a week and a half. There we go, 6.8, 6.4, and I bet they'll shave that down again. They'll probably bring it down to a 5.9. I wouldn't put it past them. I certainly would not put it past them to take it down to a 5.9, just because we won't even go there. All right, now Geophone is weighing in. They've got it at 6.8. Let's get the information on this. USGS now has it at 6.8 again. All right, well, they're bouncing it around, 6.8, 6.4. Maybe there's a tug of war happening. Well, regardless, it's a large earthquake, the largest in years, happening at the North Pole, North Arctic Circle. The physical North Pole is right here, so we're pretty far off from the physical North Pole. We're at the North Arctic Circle. And we're north of Iceland, south of Svalbard, and next to Jan Mayen, which is, again, a volcanic island in its own right. So this is tail ending off on the end of the week, and it took 4 days longer than expected for this to finally go out to the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. As we've told you so many times, the same sized earthquakes that strike down here in South Europe end up striking up here in between Iceland and Svalbard to the North Pole. Now you have proof right before your eyes, 6.8 and 6.8. From the 25th of October till now. That's how long it took. So it took a minute for that to develop out across the plates. One more time, if you're just now tuning in, the largest earthquake in years to strike up at the North Arctic Circle, and it struck, just within the past few minutes, 6.8 magnitude on the North Mid-Atlantic Ridge next to Jan Mayen Island, which is a volcano. And this follows our 6.8 that happened on the 25th down here, where we're still swarming and reeling from that. The force went up and around Romania. You can see this trail of earthquakes along the S-shaped bend of the plate, and add in a 5.5 that happened right here just a few days ago. So like a water slide, you can see it goes around Europe, and the earthquakes dropped off along the way, all the way out to the termination point. I'm, you know, again, kind of shocked to see this, actually. I mean, you know, every time it happens, we tell you to look for it all the time. But when you see the largest in years hit in both spots within the same time frame, so you see a 6.8 down here, it's the largest in years, then followed up by a 6.8 up here, the largest in years, within the same couple week time period? Yeah, if you ignore that, you're ignoring the obvious. And this is what professionals have done for a very long time. Ignored the obvious. They'll tell you they're not related. You watch. You watch. They will say this is not related. They'll say, oh, it's just chance, coincidence. You watch. It'll be the most blockheaded things, too, if they even address it at all. You go ahead and write them and ask them. Say, hey, what about the 6.8 down in Greece, followed up by a 6.8 right along dutchsinse's arrows? And they'll say, oh, that's just coincidence. And you'll say, yeah, but it's connected through with a 5.5. And they'll say, yeah, that's just coincidence too. Everything's a coincidence. Well, we know it's not. And you can see it here right before your eyes. And really, when people ignore the transfer of power, they're putting other people's lives at risk, especially if you're in a position of authority. And you ignore the transfer of energy across, it's like ignoring storms. So you can go, oh, they've just brought the earthquake back up from 6.4 to 6.7. USGS staying steady at 6.8. Europeans bouncing around right now. One more time, just now tuning in. Largest earthquake in years has struck up at the North Arctic Circle, north of Iceland, south of Svalbard, next to Jan Mayen Island, which is a volcanic island in its own right. This can be traced right down back through Romania, going right back down to our other 6.8 that hit. Two of the largest earthquakes in years in the entire area, and certainly in South Europe. We're going back at least 6 or 7 years for an earthquake this size that struck down in Greece, and up here, it's been longer. So the entire time I've been online, we maybe have dealt with a single or a couple different sixes up north, and certainly not anything near seven where we are now. Let's get the information now. Let's see if they've got anything more on the magnitudes. They're still not showing any of the magnitudes. What's this? Yeah, okay, that's not what we want. Yeah, so yeah, not showing us the magnitudes yet. Don't know what to make of that. We'll have to wait to see. Europeans have now brought it up to 6.8 to be even with the USGS. They're going to be playing around with those magnitudes for a while, but regardless of where they come in at, we know it's the same sized quake. We know that the origin point for that 6.8 was down here, and the force flowed up and around and dropped off a second 6.8 up here at the termination point. So it's not that the 6.8 down here from the 25th somehow caused shaking that then shook for days and days and days and then finally caused this up here. It's that both 6.8s were caused by a flow force coming across from the West Pacific. Now that goes back almost 2 weeks when we had our big deep earthquake event finally trail off over here in the West Pacific with the sevens that were over here. So we've been dealing with a lot of sixes and sevens, haven't we, guys? We had the 6.8 here in China. We had the 6.8 off the coast of the United States. We had the 6.8 over here at Greece. Now a 6.8 up here at the North Pole. How many 6.8s are we going to have? It's a good question, isn't it? I mean, why 6.8? Why not 6.9 or 6.7? Why are they all 6.8s over the last couple weeks? Large, huge earthquakes striking all across the planet. All 6.8s. United States coast, too. I mean, every single one of them. 6.8 right here off Vancouver. Now another one. The whole northern hemisphere moving on a 6.8 basis in the course of 2 weeks? Isn't that odd? Here, let's do this. Let's go look at the last 30 days again. And we'll just look at the sixes and higher. Or we can look at 6.8 and higher. Either or. It's going to show it either way. Here's the last month. 6.8 and higher. So here we are. USGS has it at 6.8 and a 6.6, two separate earthquakes at two different times. Okay, that's good. Glad they finally figured that out. So 6.8, 6.8, 6.8, look. And they're equal distantly spaced across the planet, the Northern Hemisphere, going from the coast of the United States across, actually, here's the way it really goes. It goes from here over to here, and this is the new one right in the middle. And which one struck first? First, this one, then this one, and then this one right in the middle fulcrum point. But this middle fulcrum point divides half the planet. It doesn't follow hardly any of our arrows except for this arrow pushing in up this way and this arrow pushing over this way and compressing in. And we get two 6.8s compressing in on each other. We get a 6.8 in the middle right at the X termination point, just as we would expect. That's not a coincidence. That's not me doing anything with the rings. I can even turn the rings off. You can still see it's equal distantly spaced 6.8s. Now we can go down a notch and go look at the sixes, and what you're going to see is an equal distance spacing of sixes going from Japan all the way down across to the South Pole here. Let me back it out so you can really see this. Again, this is not me doing anything with the earthquakes, trying to plot them out and make it look like these are equal distantly spaced. This is a perfect equal distance spacing of sixes all the way around the planet in the last month. And you don't have to take my word for it. You can go get the coordinates yourself and plot them out. Same with over in the West Pacific. Now, the earthquakes, the way they're raised high off the globe might interfere with how you might see this. Let me turn that off. You can, with the depth turned off, you can even see it better. It's just the height interferes with some people, I think, being able to really, you know, see the equal distance. See how the rings overlap perfectly on each side of the big seven going out in each direction? That's not a coincidence. So, this is the last 30 days. Bisecting the planet one way, all the way around the Pacific Ring of Fire, and making a beeline over from Europe across the North Pole. That's 6.0 and greater. Now, I can take it down another step to 5.0 and greater, and what it becomes a jumbled mess, but you can still see the equal distance spacing and following our arrows. So, the whole Indian Ocean moved in the last month, all the way around the edge with 4s and 5s, going down around the South Pole. All Southern Hemisphere moved last 30 days. Look at where we start. Our older earthquakes are in red. Okay, and our pinkish and white earthquakes striking over the past couple of weeks. And there's our 6.8 down south, which they downgraded to a 6.3. It was a 6.8 right off the bat, and then boom, immediately to 6.3, they took a half magnitude off. Fine. That's fine because the spread of sixes across the Southern Hemisphere totally shows it. I can't believe professionals missed this. You know what it is? They didn't have the tools to do it. They didn't have the real-time feeds. They didn't have... they didn't have computer access to plot it on a globe. They couldn't go back through and put the 30 days worth of earthquakes up here and look at it like this. Because if they did, they would have seen it. And then they would have discovered it. And they wouldn't be denying it. They're denying what I'm showing you right now. Their explanation is that I'm a hacker. And that I'm able to fake earthquakes and make it look like earthquakes are striking in these areas. Do you think I'm faking this 6.8? And the 6.8 that struck before it? Do you think I'm faking the arrow that's been on here for 2 years? We know how to watch for this, and the fact that they're dismissing it and trying to say it's not calls them into question, calls all their intelligence into question, calls everything into question for them not to admit it. That's even weirder than admitting it and just saying you got it wrong and did, you know, that whatever. I mean, it's that we would expect them to say, oh, yeah, look, wow, you know, that's amazing. Instead, they're like, no, this isn't happening. Dutchsinse needs to be shut down. It's... All right, well, I'm not here to complain. I'm just here to tell you. They're denying what I'm telling you right now. So here's our newest earthquake, if you're just now tuning in. Largest earthquake in years has struck up at the North Arctic Circle right on our arrow, just north of Iceland, south of Svalbard. And it's 6.8, just like the 6.8 that struck off the coast of Greece back on the 25th, 2 weeks ago, a week and a half ago. And now it's gone around Europe. The good news for the people in Italy is most of the energy has gone around you now. It's gone around to the east, dropping off a 5.5 in Romania a few days ago, 4.0 up in Poland today, and then boom, tail end right at the termination point. Cumulative total of everything that went around Europe over the past week and a half. There it is. Boom. 6.8. Elsewhere, just really quick for my Aussie viewers, you guys flew through the roof today. new 5.0 earthquake down next to Perth, southwest Australia. So it's not like North Pole is the only spot to get moving. Southern Hemisphere is also showing some activity, and we're still dealing with the deep earthquakes. We're still dealing with a lot, and there's new volcanoes on the list to top it all off. Tonight's update's going to be wild at 10 p.m. Central Time. So about an hour and 45 minutes, I will be on live. We'll do a full update. We'll look up all the quakes and all that good stuff. I'm going to save this as a video now and debut it, premiere it over on YouTube in just a few minutes so that people can get up to speed over on YouTube as to what's going on with this large quake. One more time. Largest quake in years. Largest quake I've seen in a long time, actually, up at the North Arctic Circle, striking following our other 6.8 that hit down in Greece just a few days back. So here we are, North Pole getting hit. Next stop for this should go all the way back across, if this holds true to last time, and go back down across and go back into the West Pacific. We've got ourselves something going on, guys. It's not a big thing to overlook. Right? You don't overlook big earthquakes like this. Just don't ignore it. That's the